Yo, this is Deontay the Bronze Bummer Wilder, heavyweight champion of the world, and you're watching Real Fans Real Talk.
Face facts, what up?
RealFansRealTalk.com, where Arthur Domus, Trip Young, and intern Tom, for the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro, Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend a CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics. RealFansRealTalk.com got it. They got the hottest bloggers.
Is Jeremy Lin hurt?
Well, log on to the site and you can hear it from them first. I'm talking about the latest. I'm talking about the greatest. Go check out the archives. Even tell a neighbor. Tell them Bobby sent ya. From spring to winter. Tuning in should be the only thing on your agenda. Certified cosign. You know what I'm about, son. RealFansRealTalk.com. I'm out. One. Real fans. Real talk. Real fans. Real talk. RealFansRealTalk.com. RealFansRealTalk.com. Real fans. Real talk. Real fans. Real talk. RealFansRealTalk.com. RealFansRealTalk.com.
You know, I'm pretty sure the Eagles will be dead last.
Yeah, because you know it was a heartbreaker. You know, last week, you know, with the Redskins, what they did out there. You know, they let Kirk Cousins pretty much do whatever he wanted to do. And then they just give it up the way they did in the last couple of minutes. That kind of pretty much tells the story of the Eagles season this year. And, you know, so, and yeah, in the franchise pretty much, you know, and I hate to do this because, you know, Cliff does a great job every week on Real Fans Real Talk. And if the Eagles, you know, played as well as Cliff runs the show, they might actually, you know, have experienced greatness and got to that Super Bowl. 100%. Because Cliff is the MVP here, but the Eagles are not the MVP in the NFL. Zero championship rings to date. Not going to make the playoffs, like you said, this year. So it's just, you know, sometimes, you know, you just need that extra oomph, and they just don't have it in Philadelphia. I figured, you know, when they got rid of Chip Kelly, things might have turned around for them. They got Carson Wentz. Everybody was all, you know, happy about that. He played good the first half of the season. But, you know, much like the Eagles, he just wound up falling apart. So, you know, what are you going to do, man?
Not much you can do when the Eagles are so cool. Before we leave the division, I know you mentioned before the Jerry Jones needs to shut up. I mean, they lose, you know, the only two games he's lost to was the Giants, and he just, every single week, he wants to mention Tony Romo and, like, the hypothetical situations of, if Tony Romo's going to play, like, just why are you even mentioning him?
Because it's Jerry Jones. He's an attention, you know, seeker, attention whore, I guess, however you want to call it. And, you know, he's only messing up the chemistry of the team because, you know, here you have, this is enough pressure on the quarterback in position, period. All right? Then on top of that, you have a rookie quarterback who comes in for, you know, Tony Romo is in the upper echelon of quarterbacks in the league. So you come in, and he does a great job, 11 wins in a row. They're in first place, you know, in the division, pretty, you know, in the league. And, you know, now, but every week now he's worrying about Tony Romo and what Jerry Jones is going to do and how this whole situation is going to play out. So you're putting even more pressure on Dak Prescott. Then not to mention that, you put, you know, the pressure of having to go into MetLife Stadium and play the Giants. You know, so now he loses this game, and we hear more Tony Romo. I think they just need to stop with the Tony Romo talk. If Tony Romo is healthy, which he is, that's fine. But don't, you know, take away from Dak Prescott and what he's doing, and don't get into his psyche, because that's only gonna end up bad for the Cowgirls.
You know, maybe it works in his favor because, you know, Dak Prescott, you know, feels like his job is on the line, so he's got to give it 100% every game and not get comfortable. Like, you know, but I mean, it could work both ways. I mean, well, obviously,
because, you know, now you lose the division.
Like, I, you know, earned the job. I won 11 games in a row. You know, so, like,
I mean, it's pretty much it. But you know, you do have those Cowgirl fans, which I saw, you know, on Twitter afterwards. Oh, we need Romo. Bring Romo back. Bring Romo. Bring Romo. Bring Romo. And whatnot. So you still have those people, you know, but it really does suck because Dak Prescott has had an amazing season. I mean, we're talking about him in the MVP race right now. You know what I mean? So you really can't deny what he's done this season, and it just sucks that he has to deal with Jerry Jones and the Tony Romo. First of all, Tony Romo, what does he have, 1-1 in the playoffs? I don't even understand. You know, it's not like we're talking about a Brady or you know, or Breeze or one of those guys coming back. We're talking about Tony Romo. He hasn't even been healthy the past couple of seasons. And here you have this young kid who comes in and pretty much steals the show and does everything that the Cowboys or Cowgirl fans think they should be doing every year. And, you know, they're actually winning. And they still can't just be satisfied with that. And just, you know, just accept that and dwell on it and push Dak Prescott and get behind him and support him. They still got to bring up this Tony Romo stuff. But,
well, you know what it is? Tony Romo's been there, you know, through all the losses. And Jerry Jones has been with him. And it's kind of like, if they're going to win, it's almost sad to see him be on the bench. Like, imagine if, you know.
Drew Bledsoe was that guy for the New England Patriots, and a guy named Tom Brady came along after he got hurt.
Yeah, but that was literally in the Super Bowl, so, I mean.
It turned out well. He wound up having a good one.
That's a little bit different. I mean, Drew Bledsoe was there the whole season, so it was kind of, you know, really he got them there to the promised land. Tom Brady just finished it and then stayed there. You know,
and then he got shot. Well, hey, listen, I mean, and that's even more of a reason why Dak should be the guy without, you know, any of these distractions off the field, because he came in at the beginning of the season. They have the best record in the NFL, 11 games in a row. We shouldn't even be having this discussion right now. This is, I don't care if he lost to the Giants.
Maybe because Jerry Jones is thinking of it like he's given Tony Romo all this money and he wants him to earn it. I don't know what it is. I can't make sense of it. I told you before, off camera, that I think maybe Jerry Jones just keeps mentioning it because you have any press is good press, and according to him, he's actually said that, and not many people have said that before. So it's kind of like, you know, they keep talking about the Cowgirls because Jerry Jones keeps, you know, opening his mouth and saying this nonsense with the quarterback controversy. So,
well, I had enough of Jerry Jones. I had enough of the Cowgirls. You know, so we definitely gonna move on. We got a whole lot to get to. We got a guest in the building that's gonna be coming on a little bit later in the program. Mike Ice from Under Lock and Key Entertainment. He's gonna be joining us a little bit later. Y'all know Ladybug is in the building. First of all, shout out to our other co-host, Reese, who he came in the building today. I saw him in the back. Shout out to Reese. We're going to have him come back again because he held it down, you know, when Coach Gustus was here with us. So we need that energy from the youngins again. So we're going to have to bring him back on as a guest host soon. But shout out to you, Reese. And we got a little bit of basketball that we're going to talk about because of some things going down in the NBA. You know, but actually, before we talk about the teams and the games and whatnot, I do want to, you know, mention that Craig Sager did pass away earlier today, so we definitely want to take a moment of silence for him. All right. I want to send our condolences once again to his family, all the friends, all the fans. Like, definitely one of the greatest broadcasters, commentators in basketball. Definitely, he definitely had the most style.
Yeah, I mean, him, know, and Walt Clyde Frazier with the, but he takes the cake with his. I mean, he goes, I mean, Walt Clyde Frazier's over the top, and then somehow, you know, Craig Sager goes over the top. Yeah. But
they like to outdo each other.
But I mean, you know, one of the most, one of the best interviewers out there. I mean, him and Popovich. I mean, Popovich, you know, his mentality. And then when you saw that Craig Sager was sick, he, you know, kind of really felt bad. And he started being nice to him when Craig Sager came back. And, you know, he was fighting. He got the Jimmy V Award and at the ESPYs. And just 2 days ago, he was inducted into the Broadcasting Hall of Fame, and rightfully so. And then, you know, 2 days later today, unfortunately, he passes. I mean, it's a shame because he was, you know, a lot of people were motivated and inspired by the fact that, you know, he was beating the disease, and you know, a lot of inspiration for everybody. And then it's just
and everybody loves them. It's like, you know, it's not one of those things where some people don't know. Everyone loved him. Like, this is the kind of guy he is, just a positive guy. I mean, and everybody spoke great things, from LeBron to Wade. Like you said, Popovich, everyone has been, you know, talking all day about Craig. So definitely, once again, you know, rest in peace. He would definitely be missed on the sidelines. He just brought so much joy to the sidelines. You want to see a Craig Sagan interview, even, you know, halfway through the game or at the end of the game, whatever. You want to see him speak.
You got one of those wild suits there, but he had, you know, it's always a different one. So, I mean, it's, you know, definitely not a color commentator, but he's a colorful suits. And you know. But definitely great interviews. He definitely will be missed.
All right. So we're gonna jump into the NBA really, really quickly though, because, you know, I got a shout out. We watched the Knicks game the other night, and I told you before the whole, you know, the blowout happened, I said, you know, that Porzingis might be my second favorite player. But then after, you know, the way he stepped up after he got thrown to the ground in the Suns game and he was just ready to go back at it, you know, it reminded me really of those, you know, 1990s New York Knicks teams where you knew you was going to have to be tough because a fight might break out at any point in time. So, you know, especially him coming over from Europe, I like the fact that Porzingis got back up and was ready to just throw down at the drop of a dime. He made me proud. You know, he represented New York very well on that note. The Knicks didn't win the game, but he definitely got some more fans after he, you know, the way he stepped up. Plus, he's been just playing some great basketball this entire season. So, you know, shout out to Porzingis.
Yeah, I mean, that was the fan mail question. Reggie from Queens wrote in, did you guys get that 90s New York Knicks feel when KP jumped up after being tossed to the ground in the Suns game? So, I mean, yeah, it was, you know, he's not going to take it. You can't underestimate this guy. He's a, you know, like Kevin Durant said, he's a unicorn as far as his playing, you know, his free throw percentage for the over seven footer, his 3-point shooting, his, you know, the athleticism.
The artist formerly known as Snuffleupagus.
Yeah, I mean, he's out there. You know, the rebound dunks, I just always get so hyped when he just flies in. You got, like, three big men going for the rebound, and he flies in the middle and just, like, grabs the rebound and dunks on people. He does it all the time. He's very aggressive. In this case, he gets thrown to the ground. When you look at the replay, it was a little bit of a miscommunication because he was kind of falling over, and you know, the guy thought he was pushing him and threw him, you know, kind of threw him, and ended up being a flagrant one.
In actuality, he just tripped over another player and was falling in.
But KP wasn't having that, and Jennings came out, you know, trying to back KP up too. So I mean, it was a little bit of a scuffle there for the Snuffleupagus.
Exactly, love it, man. You know, and like I said, y'all know I'm not a Knicks fan like that, but I do like Porzingis, and that just, you know, etched in stone. I mean, he might
ignited him too, because he was playing well for the game, but then he ended up scoring 34, which is a season high for him, he's definitely balling out there.
I was mad he fouled out though.
Yeah, he fouled out. I mean, they probably could have had the game if he didn't foul out, but unfortunately, that's the case right there. So,
and we're not even gonna, you know, we're not going to talk about, you know, what happened the prior couple of games back.
Yeah, we're not going to do that.
When they got beat down by the Cavs again.
I think we talked about that last week.
So they have been losing a little bit, right? But, you know, do you think they can get back on track soon before things get...
I mean, D. Rose Mello's is,
hurt.
You know,
got a little shoulder twin.
Mr.
You know?
Glass, as Samuel L. Jackson mentioned in the movie, they call him Mr. Glass. Yep. They call me Mr. Glass. That
and
is
Joakim Noah might as well be hurt the way he's been playing. So I don't know, man. I still got them in the Eastern Conference Finals, losing to the Cavs, but they got to get this stuff together. Derrick Rose got to come back, and he, you know, that back issue, I don't know what's going on with that. So he's definitely going to have to come back. And Joakim Noah actually is going to have to play, you know, some kind of basketball, because he has not been doing anything, you know, this season for the Knicks, and they definitely are going to need him. But with that being said, I do want to change the focus a little bit, because one of our own is down right now, Pop. You know, he's the floor director on Real Fans Real Talk, and he's out of commission for a little while right now. He needs surgery, and he has his GoFundMe campaign going right now. So, you know, we want you guys to, you know, to definitely, if you can, donate. He's trying to raise $1,000. He's almost to his goal right now, you know. So we definitely, you know, want to get you guys, if you can, donate. If you can't donate, you know, definitely pass the word to somebody who might be able to donate, because Pop is one of the greatest gentlemen that you will ever meet in life. He's always down to help, you know, whoever. That's just the kind of guy that he is. We got a lot of love for Pop, and we waiting for you to come back, Pop. So definitely, if you guys can, you know, like I said, that's the GoFundMe page right there. If you need any more info, you can always hit us up on the web, and we'll give you the info. RealFansRealTalk.com. Also, you can hit us up on Facebook, facebook.com/RealFansRealTalk. On YouTube, once again, just hit that subscribe button, youtube.com/RealFansRealTalk. And if you just want to hit us up on Twitter or Instagram, @RealFanTalk. And we got all the information about Pop, the GoFundMe page, and on top of that, you get everything that you want to know about Real Fans Real Talk, all in the same place. You know, once again, we definitely love Pop, and we cannot wait for him to get back, because we need you on the set, Pop, so you're going to have to hurry up and come back, man. But make sure y'all hit up that GoFundMe page, and you know, like I said, if you can donate, donate. If not, just pass the word.
The full story is there. One of the nicest guys you'll ever meet. He's almost there for the goal, so he could get the surgery done. So we hope you guys find it in your hearts to donate whatever you can. Or just help spread the word. You know, share it on Facebook, share it on Twitter. Maybe someone you know, one of your affiliates, followers, friends, whatever you want to call it. Maybe they see the story and they're willing to help. So we hope that you definitely do something, whether you share or donate yourself. So with that being said, we got a special guest on the show today, the one and only Mike Ice. Welcome to the program.
Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
What's going on, man? Good to have you. We go back some ways, back to the days over at BronxNet, and you have been very busy as of late with the television show, the music, and you got some other stuff that's going on right now as well. Can we talk about the other stuff?
Yeah, most definitely.
First of all, just update us. Let us know what's going on right now.
Well, I just finished doing a big concert series over at the Poets Den in Harlem. That was a great success. You know, I had a wine sponsor out, I had a comedian out. I like changed the showcase game up a little bit. You know, it's too many showcases with just artists. So I had poets. You know, I had dance groups and stuff like that, to that nature of the business now. So I'm just trying to change up a little bit, try to be a little different, you know. And, you know, I do what I do as far as that's concerned.
When is the next showcase going to be?
Probably maybe the end of March, early April.
So we're looking at spring for the next one?
I might do a spring break.
Okay.
Spring break.
Now, how much does it actually take to, like, going into putting these events together? Because I know it can be a headache.
Oh, man, it's a lot of hard work, man. You got to get tickets, flyers. You got to get the staff in. You got to get behind-the-scenes stuff going on, the videographer. You guys already know how it is with that, as far as that's concerned. It's a lot of work, man, but, you know, you got to love what you do. Yeah. You know, when you love what you do, you have the passion for it, you're always going to be productive. So it's like I love the work. You know, always. You know, I'm always working. Yeah. I'm everywhere. I got a couple of things coming up too, far as like tour stuff, going out of town and things like that. That's to be announced. We're working on that. I might be down Super Bowl weekend in Houston.
Okay. I'm
doing some things down there.
Okay, nice.
And maybe Mardi Gras. And just that's working, man. Y'all know I'm just working.
If y'all know about Mardi Gras, y'all better get some beads ready, because you kind of get crazy down there.
Yeah.
But that's neither here nor there. Okay, go ahead, man.
Yeah, so I heard y'all talking about the Cowboys, man.
Well, we don't.
The Cowgirls,
don't
know.
We don't know.
I'm a big Cowboy fan.
Oh my goodness!
And I heard y'all.
Well, it was nice having you on the program.
Yeah, behind the scenes, man, y'all been drilling my Cowboys. I said I got to say something, man, when I go on air, man.
Listen, the thing is, man. You know, I actually don't really have a problem with the Cowgirls. I just when they play
see,
the Giants.
See, saying Cowgirls. See,
but right, you know. They did just lose
instinct.
To the Giants. Yeah, it's a natural thing. I think the best part about us saying the Cowgirls is that, you know, when Ladyboy came on the show, she didn't really, she didn't really address the cowgirls like that anyway. But from being around us so often, the first time she described them as the cowgirls, it just melted our hearts, man. Because it's a beautiful thing.
That's when we knew she was
official part of the team. I'm just glad I ain't wearing my cowboy jersey. Y'all would have probably really roasted me.
It would have had to go down.
Y'all probably would have kicked me off air, right?
Yeah, it would have had to go down. No, we would have left you on air because, you know, after the Giants put that beat down on them, you know, this past Sunday, you know, two in the season. They only got two losses this season, which is good. But both losses came to the Giants, you know. And one thing about the Giants is in the playoffs, the Giants are the team that you don't want to see.
Well, we're going to see y'all down the line.
So,
we want to see y'all.
Well, if, because you guys.
I don't think you want to see.
Yeah, I don't think you do want to see us.
We obviously have the answer for you guys.
When was the last time that the Cowgirls won a playoff game?
Come on.
Was it?
When basically, like, let me see. I guess Detroit.
That was a long time ago, though, right?
No, it wasn't. It was like maybe 2 years ago. We lost the Green Bay.
The following week. Now, the catch that wasn't a catch.
Yeah, the catch that wasn't a catch. Now, what about the placeholder that wasn't a placeholder, and they couldn't get the kick right?
Because
I remember that.
Caused them an accident waiting to happen.
But you know what? You know what? It's funny that y'all saying that, man, because this is a new day. And new age, you know what I mean? And we got two rookies that's going to be competing for the MVP.
Nothing.
And your quarterback almost gave us the game. You know?
No, he didn't give you the game.
Eli
right?
Manning is real terrible at times. Y'all got to say that. He's terrible at times.
It was raining, all right? He had a couple of slip-ups. It's about the finish. Not how you start, it's how you finish.
All right.
But I do, as a Cowgirls fan, I do want to ask... You know, your take on this whole, you know, the Jerry Jones triangle offense they got going on, the love affair he has with Tony Romo, and, you know, what's up? Why is he not just wholeheartedly just shutting up and throwing the
support
behind Dak?
You know, Jerry always wants to be in the media, so he actually always talks about Tony Romo. He's dedicated to Tony Romo. Tony Romo got him, you know. Certain places and he can do spectacular.
He get him because he ain't got no rings.
I'm talking about when he first came in and was, you know.
I think it was from back when Tony Romo used to date Jessica Simpson and maybe him
that's
and Jerry
things
Jones
went downhill.
That's why.
Did you know Jerry? He's always dedicated to a certain player. So he got love for Tony Romo. I'm sold on Dak right now.
As you should be. I mean, the smart money is on Dak.
I think we need to move on.
We're talking about a 36-year-old right now with back problems.
The Jets need a quarterback, so.
The Jets need a whole lot.
You send them over there.
More than just don't send no injury-prone quarterback to the Jets. They got enough issues as it is.
That's the thing when anyone criticizes Eli. I always say, like, who else are we supposed to get? Like, Eli is at least a top 10 quarterback. It's not easy to get a quarterback like Eli Manning. I mean, the Jets draft, like, 3 quarterbacks a year. And they can't get anybody to do anything. So I
think it's more their offensive coordinators as play calling. I think so.
They
have talent.
They have talent. But you know what? Geno didn't pan out for the Jets. Fitzpatrick...
They're not pocket quarterbacks, though.
But at the same time, they didn't want to commit to Fitzpatrick, and he came to training camp like 5 seconds before training camp started.
Exactly.
So they gave it to him kind of last minute and everything. And, I mean, I think if they would have signed him in the spring and said, hey, you're our quarterback, then maybe it would have been a little bit different. Yeah. But he wasn't able to work out with the team. He wasn't signed with them. And then that's a whole debacle there. They can never figure out anything.
The sad part about the Jets is that the quarterback that has actually done the best for the Jets in maybe like the past 10 years is Mark Sanchez.
No.
Like he's the one that's taken them to the AFC Championship.
I got coach on that. I think Testaverde. I mean, he got the AFC Championship.
That's before. But I mean,
Mark Sanchez had
defense.
He got
two AFC Championships. Yeah, that's.
He had a defense.
I mean, listen.
He was spectacular.
What else did they have?
Was definitely passed 10 years ago.
But Testaverde was good.
No, Testaverde was good.
He actually was the best option for them to go to the Super Bowl than anybody else. He got into the AFC Championship.
They also had Curtis Martin at that time too, so they had one of the top 10 running backs in the league.
Yeah.
Actually, they did have a better team at that time, but they just couldn't get it done. And now we're in a new era where they've went through how many starting quarterbacks over the past couple of seasons? They haven't drafted well at all. As far as, you know, the quarterbacks go, they did, you know, do well on the defensive side of the football. But, you know, they were getting hurt. And then, you know, Revis, you have Revis. And he's washed up now at this point. Like, I don't know if he's going to try to play. He might try to get the check next season. But, you know, there's no more Revis Island, none of that.
No, that's over.
This season, it was embarrassing for you know, Revis. And it sucks because I was a huge fan of Revis, but it's at that time, you know, understand why the Patriots wasn't trying to keep him. They knew it was downhill from there. But, you know, it's a lot of things going on with the Jets.
I mean, I think, you know, maybe, you know, the Jets knew too, but it's like Revis is coming back. He's got false hope to the Jets to sell tickets because they don't sell out like the Giants do.
Nah.
So, you know, they're trying to give away tickets sometimes.
Well, they need something. They definitely need a boost.
But back to the Cowgirls, though. I do want to ask you this, since you are the Cowgirls fan here today. Ezekiel Elliott or Prescott, who do you think is more deserving of the MVP award?
I think Elliott, more consistent.
Okay.
100 yards a game.
Except for when he plays the Giants.
No, he got 100.
Not the first
time. He got 100 this game.
This game. Not the first
he got 100 this game.
But you know what?
He's leading the league in rushing.
But when you lose, does it matter?
Huh?
Does it lose?
We're 11-2. Y'all make it seem like we're in the basement. Like we with the Eagles and the Redskins. Come on, man.
You know what? I like how you said that.
Come on.
That's why the Eagles are throwing that out. Because you got the enemy of enemy is my friend type of thing. That's why you try to play
that. We got an Eagles fan in the back.
Y'all killing me, man.
Listen,
we owe y'all. We owe the Giants, the Eagles, and the Redskins. They knocked us out the playoffs 3 years in a row. This is our year. Everybody got to sit back.
I'm just going to let you know right now, if you watch the playback on this show and at some point your mic got cut off, it's because you made that comment about the Eagles and the technical director is an Eagles fan.
My mic is cut off.
So I just want to let
you
know.
That's like me Starbuck Wilders. Cut his mic.
That's it might happen. But you know what? But I do want to get back a little bit to what you have going on and with the show. And you're getting ready to start up again.
Right.
So just tell us a little bit about the show and what can we expect.
Well, the first quarter, we're going to actually drop a lot of projects. You know, I manage artists, too. Shout out to Goldie Locks and Angie Milani, Haas Boogie, Destruct, JMO. Mm-hmm. I manage 5 artists. They're on the contract with me. We just finished a mixtape that's doing real good in the streets, business as usual.
Okay.
And we just working, man. We just finished doing a freestyle. We did a remix of For The Fam. That Jay-Z and them did. And we getting a lot of press on that. A lot of people hitting us up on that. We performed it at the Conscious Series, and we got standing ovation for that. And you're just working, man. It's beautiful to actually do what you do, and people love what you do. We have people all over the world checking in from Africa, from Spain, from London, L.A., you know, San Diego, I could name everywhere, Detroit, Miami, you name it, people just checking in, man. We have a fan base all over the place. So, you know, just shout out to everybody that's working out there. You guys, man, I love y'all show, man. I always wanted to come on y'all show, man.
Appreciate it.
I actually, you know, I'm a fan of you guys. I used to watch y'all on TV. I'm sitting in the house watching y'all on TV, right? And I was like, yo, they got a hot show. I always want to go on their show. And I see how y'all was interviewing Anthony Mason and all the other celebs. And I like the whole setup. I remember the Brooklyn jersey right there. I had one of those. Mm-hmm. And I just want to take my hat off to you guys, man. You know, congratulations to y'all on y'all Beta Awards. Like it's always, it, man. It's always well deserved, though.
Yeah.
It's like your category, when y'all win, I feel that y'all won. You know what I'm saying? You know how it is when you feel like, oh, somebody should have else won or something like that. But I felt every year y'all win because y'all put work in. I love the way y'all put y'all work in, man. I just want to salute y'all on that, man. And I'm a big fan of y'all.
And we definitely appreciate that. And you brought up the Anthony Mason video. And, you know, yesterday was, you know, he passed away yesterday, a couple of years ago now. And that, you know, was, you know, for myself and, you know, Statman, one of our best interviews. I mean, one of my favorites. I know Statman's one of your favorites. And, you know, we're talking about a guy in Anthony Mason who, if you saw him on the court,
right,
and then you knew him in real life, it's probably two complete opposites, because you know, you might get scared you see Anthony Mason in real life, but definitely one of
on the court you're gonna be scared.
On the court you'd be scared. But you in real life, he's kind of kind-hearted, genuine dude. And I tell this story all the time because, like, he's just a great guy. But you know, I met, you know, Anthony Mason through one of my old employers, and we linked up, and I spoke to him, and I asked him to come on the show. He said, "Yeah, I'm gonna do it. Take my number, blah blah blah." And then some time went past. And you know how sometimes you people say they're gonna do the show, and right, they don't do the show.
Right.
But you know, he kept his word. He had me and his stat man, even though he forgot, he had me and stat man drive all the way to his office in Manhattan, which he was not there to shoot the interview. But his secretary calls him up, and he's like, "Yo, you know, I'm at the house. If y'all want to come through," and I looked at stat man, he looked at me, he said, "Hell yeah, we want to come through to the house and do this interview." So we drive all the way back uptown, to, you know, past the Bronx and whatnot, and you know, we sit doing down a couple of hours with Mace, and you know, we just a great interview came out of that, and I also, just going through my archives, through the hard drives, I wound up finding some footage of Anthony Mason that I actually never actually released. I hadn't put out. And so you guys are actually in for a treat. You know, a little bit of Rucker footage from Anthony Mason. It's, you know, Anthony Mason Jr. is there. It's right after Team Uwe won the EBC Classic at the Rucker Park. Myself and the Statman were out there. So I said, you know what? Since yesterday marked the anniversary of his death, we're gonna you know, show some of the positive and the things that we experienced and the good times that we had with him, because that was definitely a fun night. Anytime you get the chip, you know, that's always a good night. Shout out to OMP and Team Uwe. They won that year, and Anthony Mason Jr. Antoine Mason was also there as well. So we're gonna actually play that footage for you guys. No one else has seen this.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, taking photos, and then, I mean, it's not as in detail as the interview. The interview was great, but yeah, one of the things I never mentioned on camera, because this was off camera with me and Mace, and it contains some language, but there's quite some stories that were off camera, but this one, you know, I told him he was my second favorite Nick of all time. And he said, "Second favorite? What kind of bleep is that?" And he's like, "What, are you a Ewing fan?" I was like, "Of course, I'm a Ewing. Everyone's a Ewing fan if you're a Knicks fan. He's got to be number one." But definitely great chatting with him on camera and off camera. Kind-hearted guy, and he comes over to his son's game. And, you know, both of his sons were there, and it was a great event.
Yeah. And shout out to Anthony Mason Jr. too, because he just went out and we weren't able to come, but him and Larry Johnson and the rest of the family on three, they were at the Children's Hospital in the Bronx just visiting with the kids. Nice. And whatnot, and he continues to do great things in our community, and we always applaud that, you know, especially, you know, when you have a little bit of a, you know, celebrity status, it's your obligation, honestly, to give back to your community, because, you know, listen, at the end of the day, we know people open up doors for you when you have that. So it's good that he continues to give back. You know, we came out to the Kicks for Confidence. You know, we came out to, you know, his event in Queens with John Starks for the charity, and the kids are amazing. And he continues to work in our community and work with our youth, and that is something that's definitely applause-worthy. So shout out to Anthony Mason Jr. Shout out to the whole family on three, Vance, Chrissy, all of you guys are doing an amazing job. But we're going to jump into this video, and when we come back, Ladybug will be here, and she got some rumors. You know, the rumor mill is back. It's some hot stuff been going on, so I'm waiting to hear what Ladybug got to say. But we're going to jump into to this video, man. Rest in peace.
Hey, it's your girl Bianca Bonnie from Love & Hip Hop New York. You already know I'm rocking with Real Fans Real Talk.
RealFansRealTalk.com, where Arthur Thomas, Trip Young, and Intern Tom, for the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro, Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend the CAT scan. And if
I tried to climb in on the last one.
Trip.
Butter.
Oh, wow.
Nice one ever had, though.
The other two, though, they were throwing them too hard.
He's actually leaning.
Picture with y'all? I got a picture for y'all. My little brother. Oh, all right, y'all three. 25 things. 3, 2, 1. Good.
Jackson. Phil Jackson get out there and be doing some shit. That motherfucker got there. He ain't get there.
Oh, he ain't get there.
EBC right now, you dead? Got my pops, my brother.
Oh, yeah, you be good, man.
Doing good. Junior. Who way or no way? Right. He living. Always good to show love to the bloodline. New York City. Memphis, Tennessee, we out here. Got my from the side, we out here. KD.
My soul. Love. My people. Shot town. My big homie the long way, man.
Take a picture of my son.
Back live, ladies and gentlemen, Real Fans, Real Talk. Mark the Stat Manskevich, Trip Young, our guest Mike Ice, and the one and only Ladybug. Hey. And of course, I talked about that story, and then the next time I'm seeing him, I'm wearing a Ewing jersey. it wasn't planned to do that, but I happened to have the Ewing jersey there. But yesterday would have been his birthday, and, you know, rest in peace, Anthony Mason. But we do have Ladybug here. I know the fans on Twitter and social media and everything always hit us up because, you know, she didn't make an appearance recently. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you're disappointed a lot of people. Yeah, you know, we don't want people to stop watching, so we got to give them their dose of Ladybug.
I'm sorry. It's been a lot going on. I miss you guys as always. I try and keep up as always. I miss you guys. It's crazy how the world turns because me and Mike Ice, that's a long way. But as always, it's your favorite Ladybug here with the Rumor Mill. As you guys know, I'm keeping up with this whole Mayweather-McGregor deal, and it's just getting juicier. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. The female in me is just itching drama. It's itching. So recently we heard that Conor McGregor just received his boxing license in California. So that's one step closer to him just getting under Mayweather's skin, trying to get that fight, really trying to make this happen. Now, Mayweather, money team, you know, Trip Young advocates the money team heavily.
Go ahead, Ladybug.
You know, I gotta get it out.
He's itching to say it. Basically, he gave a response now. As only Mayweather does with his one line of responses, he goes and he says he will slap the sugar honey iced tea out of McGregor when he sees him. Yes, that was, you know, we're on live TV, can't say certain things, but we get the gist of it. That's his response. So he's saying as soon as he sees him, they ain't got to wait for pay-per-view. They ain't got to wait for nobody to sign no contracts. It just may happen. So
hold on. First of all, Where's my camera, please? Put me on camera, please. Oh, get close up. Zoom. Come on. Get in close. Get in close on me. Get in close on me. You know I got to say this. Every time she bring up this Mayweather stuff, I got to say this. Get in my camera. Please. Thank you guys in the back.
I'm sorry.
I'm down with the money team. You know it, man. I had to get it out. I was itching. As soon as you said Mayweather, I was itching to get it out, Ladybug. You know, and first of all, let me just say this, because I'm tired of this. All right, I'm to the point where I actually do want to see them get in the ring and fight. Now, if Mayweather slapped him in the ring while they was boxing, that would you know, be the bee's knees for me right there. You know, but I don't want you to slap him in the street, because I don't want you to, you know, get a charge. Like, that's, you know, that's, first of all, that's a threat you just made, you know, in publicly. So I don't want you to get, you know, locked up behind this, Mayweather. You know, you already had those kind of issues before. We don't need you going back. So, you know, don't slap him in public. Slap him in the ring after you knock him out.
Plus, he might get his butt whipped if he's locked
in the street.
That's not a boxing fight anymore, yeah. Then. Now you're on different terms.
Unless
in the boxing,
you might knock him out.
He'll wipe the floor with him in the boxing ring.
Yeah.
But you all do that in the street, it becomes a UFC match with no cage to boundaries.
Yeah, that's no holds barred. Then that's different. That's WWE chairs, tables, ladders, and chairs match. Anything goes.
The low blows and whatever.
Exactly.
But so you guys know, I follow the athletes. But this is just something I just gonna follow because I just like this type of drama. Don't judge me. Anyway, moving on. Talking about drama and craziness. The Lakers were scheduled to stay at the Trump Soho Hotel while they were here in New York playing against the Brooklyn Nets. They recently decided to not stay at the Trump Hotels due to security reasons. Now, these security reasons, if you've seen in the news, included in different properties, random people going looking for Trump, you know, our president-elect, trying to find him. There's, you know, people that are supporting, looking for him, trying to tell him good things. There are people not supporting him, looking for him also.
Was Kanye there?
That's not for this.
You seen that, right?
Definitely follow realfansrealtalk.com for that. I have something for that one. But we're definitely going to keep it to the Lakers. I feel like the franchise is definitely doing something smart, because every day in the news we're hearing somebody's trying to go into these buildings doing something. Somebody's trying to look for this man. And we don't want the franchise to be a casualty, because they're all, you know, public celebrity figures. And that's a lot of money in one building. And people know that these security measures, people are getting smarter. These hackers, these computer people, these people can pinpoint a person just like this. So I feel like it's smart for the Lakers to kind of, you know, not be in that, because that has nothing to do with them. And it's unfortunate that they have to really relocate and renegotiate things after this. So
Kobe's not on the Lakers, so there's really nobody important there anymore.
I did not say that. To all the Lakers fans out there, okay, camera, that wasn't me.
It is what it is. You might have a point, Stat Man. You know, they did lose to the Knicks a couple of nights ago too, so you know, things are changing. It's so over for that. I just would like, you know, for Trump to have me get up out of New York, because the traffic has been crazy. So I wanted to get back a little bit back to normal. You know, once he goes into the White House or whatever, then things can actually calm down a little bit in the city.
So that's something we're going to keep on also. This is something that I kind of, because, you know, I'm in the social media world, and I kind of agree with this. Lately, recently the MLB banned the rookies, the whole hazing ritual, them dressing up and, you know, really inappropriate. Some inappropriate, no, just some. I feel like this is a very sensitive topic because everybody has their own opinions, but I feel like the response that was getting back was, it was a social media's fault, because social media was publicizing this. You know, the MLB was probably doing this forever with rookies. You know, it's like going into sororities and fraternities. They have these little things you have to do, and it's not always the greatest, it's not always the funniest, and probably not always the best thing, but to get in, you had to do it. And before, it was no cameras, it was no social media to say, oh, look, ooh, they're doing this, this is bad. Now that this is being publicized, I feel like, you know, the opinions is now taking over, something that happened forever. But the MLB officially banned the hazing rituals, as they say, the cross-dressing, them parading in, you know, scantily clad outfits and things like that. So how do you guys feel?
I'm in full support of that.
Full support.
All right, listen, you know, each his own, if however you feel like you need to feel, but I'm not with that dressing, you know, men up as women and parading them around like that and whatever else they was doing with that. I'm not cool with that. If I understand rookie hazing, so if you want to put the bill on me at the restaurant, I'll do that. But I don't care if rookie or not, whoever, we was going to have a problem because I wasn't going to be in no dress.
Well, you remember so, back when they was rookies, they made them go get water and, yeah, that's, and stuff okay like that. I'm okay with all that, yeah, but the other stuff is out of question. Yeah, that's out of question. Yeah,
we don't do carry those.
The bags and yeah, whatever. Yeah, exactly. Like that. That's little cool things like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, little things like
I told
that
you, I even take the tab, but I'm not putting on no yeah dress. So if that was the case, then either I wasn't going to be on that team, or you know, we were just going to have some kind of problem because it wasn't going down like that.
I remember with the Cowgirls, with Des Bryant was a rookie. Oh, yeah. They made him. They were trying to make him wear the book pack or something like that, like the Hello Kitty book pack. They were doing that to the rookies or something. I forgot what it was with Des Bryant, but Des Bryant didn't want any part of it. That was the whole issue. I don't
is
know
that
if you
part
remember
of the Cowboys.com thing?
The,
is that part
to
of the website?
The goalpost, too. Remember, there's a time to yeah, the goalpost yeah and leave them out there for a while and yeah then come back and get them.
They did
that
not
was cool, too. So, you know.
Listen, as long as you're not. Why, like, what, why well, do you need to put a man in a dress?
I mean, if that's their choice, people who do that, whatever. But
yeah, on their own.
Yeah,
to do that to rookies,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
and, you know.
That's not cool.
The,
yeah.
Demasculating them or whatever, and, yeah, you know,
I mean, if
embarrassing
you know, like, Caitlyn Jenner, that's her thing. That's fine. Right. We're talking about just regular, you know, athletes and stuff
that's
like that. We're not down.
Cross-tracking dressing, yeah, that's a whole different
well,
subject.
You know, but we're not, we ain't going to get
okay,
it.
Okay, that's
see,
y'all peeling away layers. That doesn't have to be peeled away.
You know, we just want to make sure, I just want to make sure when Trump said, you know,
focused, that's what
the man in the dress, like people who yeah do that on their own choice, there's nothing wrong with it, you know,
yeah,
that's
okay
their choice.
So,
like,
you know, go ahead, Ladybug.
As Ladybug, I speak for Real Fans, Real Talk, we support everybody. It's just they don't feel like the rookie should do it. So it's okay.
The fine print over there.
Yeah.
But my thing also is that, you know, if social media didn't publicize it, this wouldn't even be a conversation right now, too.
Yeah, you're right, but that's the age we're in. Everything is on social media. Our conversation right now is already on Twitter. They're talking about it.
And that's what it is, but I just feel like, you know, certain things, and like I said, you know, everybody to each his own, but I just feel like nowadays society allows too much in, you know, too much people inside and too much people opinions to take over the overall goal and the overall reasoning. Like you said, there used to be people getting tied up, you know, to go post or grab and stuff. Probably somebody thought that was too harsh or somebody thought that was
so
too.
Said, let's put him in a dress.
Hey, you know, some
let's
people be like, oh, that's
here, right?
Yeah,
let's
put him in a dress.
But that's how vast opinions are. It's crazy. That's how quick opinions can sway a whole thing. Some people, there'll be a group of people that thinks, oh my gosh, it's cruel and unruly to have somebody tied up, but if we just put them in a dress, it's harmless fun. But you, on the other hand, was like, I'd rather take the tab than put somebody in a dress. But that's how that's how much
only,
society goes. It's crazy.
Only person
but,
that I'm okay with in that is Madea. That's the only person I'm accept that with. Or Big Mama. If they make Big Mama's house full, I'm going to support that. But other than that, I ain't with that.
So, on a more serious note, and you know I always like to commend celebrities when they have to go outside of themselves, outside of their money, outside of their stature, and really take care of themselves, excuse me. And it's crazy because I said this a few months before, but Lamar Odom is going back into rehab. He's trying rehab again, which is something I always commend. You know, it's hard to break a habit. It's hard to kick a habit. And especially in this celebrity, when you have access to things at your disposal, you have money and all these resources at your disposal to really come outside of yourself and go back and take care of yourself is something that I commend. And outside of the Kardashian curse that social media likes to portray.
I mean, if
you look at men, went through there, right?
I'm just saying, you know, Lamar's in rehab. Kanye got mental issues yeah now, he's saying. Robert Kardashian, you know, he's just all over the place. And
so,
then,
to be fair, Kanye probably had mental issues.
Yeah, he might have had those before. And then, you know, Bruce said, if you can't beat him, join him. So, I don't, you know.
I remember a couple of years ago, they said, you know, I can't wait to see what happens to Kanye.
And it's crazy to say, but, you know, recently on social media, Lamar Odom and his family, they've been posting more pictures together. You know, his family has been supporting him. he's just really trying to get it together. And he does have, you know, his other celebrity friends, old players, just old colleagues really coming behind him and saying, listen, you can do this. You're strong. You've been in this. It's not your first go round. You know, you have less distractions. I like when they like, you know, they like to distractions. Man. So, you know, big shout outs to him. And, you know, it's hard to kick a habit, like I said. And when you have those things at your disposal, it's good to it on your own. So
definitely, I know we joke around, but that, you know, it's, drug addiction is a very serious issue. You know, and coming from, you know, my mom is a substance abuse counselor, so you know I've been around this for a long time, and I know it's hard to kick a habit once you have it. It's a sickness. So we definitely support Lamar Odom in that, and we wish you all of the best with your recovery. We hope that you can stay clean this time, brother.
Yeah, so definitely. So those are my topics for this week. Make sure you guys stay tuned all the time, every week here. And also follow us on realfansrealtalk.com and check out my vlogs.
All right, we got one more fan mail question before we wrap things up. Lance from South Beach wrote in, Oscar De La Hoya guaranteed a super fight between Canelo Alvarez and Triple G in 2017. Do you guys think it will happen? And who do you have winning if it does?
I would like for it to happen, but the way, you know, boxing is set up right now, I mean, it took us a while to get Mayweather Pacquiao, so I'm not sure. But he did say, you know, he was guaranteeing that it was going to happen.
I mean, he bet his promoter's license on it. I mean, that's what he said on you know,
so
on
if it does happen, I think for me, it would depend on the weight class that they fight at. If they fight where Triple G is at right now, then I'm going to say Triple G. But if Triple G has to go down, I might lean a little bit towards Canelo, you know, but we got to wait and see. But I would love to see that fight next year. That would be up there. Well, the hype would be up there at least, you know, because Mayweather Pacquiao wasn't a good fight.
De La Hoya says September of 2017, to be more specific. But unfortunately, it's not, you know, definite on his say-so. But one last topic. We're running low on time. Adrian Peterson, second practice day in a row. If he does come back, he might not come back this week, but if he does come back, what do you think that means for the Vikings?
Well, it depends. Like I said, if he doesn't come back this week, it's just, I mean, because it could be too little too late, him coming back next week. They have to actually win this weekend to keep the hopes alive, because Detroit is in first place right now. Yeah. And then, I mean, the way the Packers have been playing the last couple of weeks, Aaron Rodgers looks like MVP Aaron Rodgers. And that defense, I mean, they destroyed Russell Wilson, 5 interceptions. You know, so if he can come back, but like I said, they got to win.
They're still somewhat in the hunt you know, for the wild card, even if they don't win the division. They're at 7-6 right now. Lions are at 9-4. So the 2 games behind.
As Al Davis said, just win, baby, win.
Similar to, you know, the Giants situation, except the Giants are much more comfortable in the wild card position. They're pretty much, if they don't win the division, they almost have that, you know, wild card on lock with 1 win out of the next 3. So
that's the thing. Really quick, because I know we're getting up out of here. Next week, Christmas special. We got the youth activists that are a part of the Yaya Network, and, you know, myself, Ladybug, and the Statman, we teamed up. We wanted to do something nice for the kids. So, well, the youth, you know, the youth, they're not little kids. You know, they're older. They're training right now. But so we got them some Christmas gifts, some Timberlands, and a couple other things that we got for them because they've been working so hard.
Santa got them, though, so.
Santa. Why we gotta always give Santa Claus the credit for everything? Why we can't give credit?
Why we can't give ourselves the credit?
When we doing positive things in the community, why we can't give ourselves some credit?
That's true. You're right.
That's all I'm trying to say. I love Santa Claus, too. But you know what? We doing positive stuff, too. And we're going to continue to do positive things in the community because that's what we're
saying. Santa, even though it's the holiday season.
I'm not saying you're taking it to the extreme right now. Exactly. I ain't saying all that. I love Santa. You know, I still believe in Santa Claus and the magic of Christmas, but I'm just saying, you know, we
Miracle
have to give ourselves credit too, because
we're doing
positive, you know, in our community
we're definitely whatnot.
So. It's funny you said that. I'm doing a toy drive too, so man, shout out to you on that.
Oh, you know, really quick, Mike, just tell them where they can reach you at before we
get
out
of here. Definitely. www.underlockandkey.ent, Mike Geis on Facebook, Instagram, Mike Geis, ULK, YouTube, Lock and Key, ENT 365. And that's where you can reach me.
And the info for the toy drive.
The toy drive, you can reach me there. You can reach me at lockandkey@yahoo.com. And I also got a web series. If you guys are free, I want y'all to come do a cameo. that I'm doing right now. Really so. Plug Danny in real quick. Shout out to Malaga Hooper. We filmed in the cold in New Jersey this last Sunday. Man, we was freezing, but we got it in. But I would like all of y'all to come out, get a cameo.
Love to be there. Definitely. We're out of time. Shout out to Mike Ice, of course, the one and only Ladybug and Trip Young. I'm Mark the Statman Skevich. Thank you all for joining us on Real Fans Real Talk.
Good night.
And we'll see you next week.
Real fans, realtalk.com. Where Arthur Domus, Trip Young, and intern Tom. For the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro, Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend a CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics. Real fans, realtalk.com. Got it. They got the hottest bloggers.
Did Jeremy Lin hurt?
We'll log onto the site and you can hear it from them first. I'm talking about the latest. I'm talking about the greatest. Go check out the archives. Even tell a neighbor. Tell a Bobby sent ya from spring to winter. Tuning in should be the only thing on your agenda.